Om namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
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 Shri Bhagavan Uvacha.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha.
Kutas
tva
kashmalam
idam
vishome
samupastitam
anarya
jushtam
asvargyam
akirtikaram
Arjuna.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha.
Kutastva kashmalamidam.
Kutastva kashmalamidam.
Vishame samupastitam.
Vishame samupastitam.
Anaya jushtam asvargyam.
Anaya jushtam asvargyam.
Akirtikaram Arjuna.
Akirtikaram Arjuna.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha.
The Supreme Personality of Godhead said,
Kutaha,
wherefrom, tva,
unto you,
koshmolam,
dirtiness,
idam,
this lamentation,
vishome,
this hour of crisis,
samupastitam,
arrived.
Anardya,
persons who do not know the value of life.
Jushtam,
practiced by.
Asvargyam,
that which does not lead to higher planets.
Akirti,
infamy.
Karam,
the cause of.
Arjuna,
O Arjuna.
Translation.
The Supreme Person, Bhagavan, said,
My dear Arjuna, how have these impurities come upon you?
They are not at all befitting a man who knows the progressive values of life.
They do not lead to higher planets, but to infamy.
So, in this verse, in Vyasadeva, is writing, of course, the speaking is through Sanjaya, but the original writer is Vyasadeva. For in other slokas, he writes Arjuna Uvaj, Sanjaya Uvaj, like that. So similarly, he could write here Krishna Uvaj. He could write. No, he's writing Bhagavan Uvaj. So Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. By this writing, it is established. See, Bhagavan Uvaj. He cannot be equal with Arjuna or Sanjaya or anybody else. Asamartha. Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is supreme. Nobody is equal to him, nobody is higher than him. Everyone is lower. That is the meaning of Bhagavan. Nobody can claim, I am Bhagavan. But nowadays there are so many rascals, they are claiming that everyone is Bhagavan. The Vyasadeva is mistaken. Actually, these Mahavadi philosophers, they are so great rascals, they sometimes say like that, the Vyasadeva is also mistaken. They have got the audacity to say Vyasadeva he is accepted as incarnation of Narayana, who has given us the Vedic literature, not so many books he has given, the Vedas, the Puranas, Mahabharata, Srimad Bhagavatam, Vedanta Sutra, everything is given by Vyasadeva in writing, and he has accepted Narayana, incarnation of Narayana, Mahamunikrite. He is also Vyasamuni, but he is also said Mahamunikrite. So there cannot be any mistake in the words of Vyasadeva. This is the difficulty. If one does not come through the channel of disciple succession, so they are in so many ways mistaken. Vyasadeva is above all this. He is not an ordinary writer for material description, for material name and fame. He cannot be mistaken. As Bhagavan, Krishna cannot be mistaken. Similarly, Vyasadeva, incarnation of Bhagavan, he also cannot be mistaken. Neither devotee of Krishna can be mistaken. Devotee of Krishna, he does not say anything as his own opinion. He never says. What Krishna says, he says. He may be not perfect, but what Krishna has said, that is perfect. Therefore, a pure devotee who does not say anything beyond which was spoken by Krishna, therefore his statement is also without mistake. Common man within this material world, he commits mistake to err is human. Even big personality, they commit mistake. But Narayana para, he is transcendental. Krishna is transcendental. There cannot be any mistake. There cannot be any illusion. Those who are within this material world, they have got four defects. They commit mistake, they are illusioned, and their senses are imperfect, brahma pramad vipulisha, and they are cheaters. Because just like modern day scientists and philosophers, they propagate so many branches of knowledge. But when on the crucial point they are caught, they say, I do not know perfect. I do not know perfect. We are trying to know, in future we shall tell you the perfect. But if you are not in perfect knowledge, why should you take the post of a teacher? If your knowledge is imperfect, then whatever you speak, that is imperfect. Therefore, with imperfect knowledge, why you should become a teacher? That is cheating. That is cheating. Therefore, purposefully, Vyasadeva is writing, see Bhagavan Vacha, where there is no cheating, no imperfection, no illusion, no mistake. Four things. No mistake, no illusion, no cheating, and no imperfection. This is Bhagavan. Why you are taking Bhagavad Gita so seriously? There are so many other books we can read. So many theories, so many philosophers, big philosophers. But we cannot take them because they are defective. The author is sure to commit mistake, his illusion, because his senses are not perfect, therefore imperfection. So with all these defects, we cannot accept anyone's knowledge. This is Vedic process. This is called parampara system, disciplic succession. We receive knowledge perfectly from the Supreme Bhagavan. And if I receive the knowledge from Bhagavan, and if I distribute the same knowledge as Bhagavan has said, without any interpretation of my cheating policy, then the knowledge which I distribute, that is also perfect. I may not be perfect, but the knowledge which I have taken from Krishna, if I present it as it is, without any interpretation, then what I give you, that is perfect. It is very easy to understand. I have given several times. Just like a peon has brought a money order for you, $1,000. So he is giving you. So you cannot say, here is a peon, he is a poor man, how he can give me $1,000? He is not giving. The money is sent by somebody else, he is simply handing you over. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Amar Agnaya Guru Haiya, Taro Sarva Desh, Taro Ehi Desh. He is asking everyone to become a spiritual master. So how everyone can become spiritual master? A spiritual master has sufficient knowledge and so many other qualifications. No, even without any qualification, one can become spiritual. How? Now the process is, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Amara Agnaya, on my order. That is the crucial point. One does not become spiritual master by his own whims. That is not spiritual master. He must be ordered by superior authority. Then he is spiritual. Amaratta. Just like in our case, our superior authority, our spiritual master, he ordered me that you just try to preach this gospel, whatever you have learned from me in English. So we have tried it, that's all. It is not that I am very much qualified. The only qualification is that I have tried to execute the order of superior authority. That's all. This is the secret of success. Vyavasātmika buddhi rekeha kurunandana bahu sākha jhanantāsya buddhi abhyavasāyina. Bahu shakha anantas. Bahu shadmika buddhi, nischadmika buddhi. If one has got unflinching faith in Krishna and Guru, Guru Krishna Kripa, we have to receive mercy both from the spiritual master and Krishna. We cannot jump over to Krishna. That is another nonsense. We must approach Krishna through Guru. That is parampara system. Krishna is not so cheap thing that you can jump over. Somebody says, no, why shall I accept Guru? I can approach Krishna directly. No. Krishna does not accept such. Mad bhaktya puja bhudika. Krishna said, the first of all, you become devotee of my devotee. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Gopi Bhattu Padakamalayo Dasu Dasu Dasanu Dasu. I am the servant of the servant of the servant of Krishna. This is called parampara system. You have to learn how to become servant of the servant of Krishna. The more you become in the lower position, servant, 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 100 times servant, servant, then more you are advanced. Here in this material world, everyone is trying to be master of the master. Just opposite. And the spiritual world, the endeavor is to become servant, servant. This is the secret. Jasya devi parabhakti jatha devi tatha guru tasyaite kutita jhartya prakashanti mahatmana. This is Vedic instance. So Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, in connection with the verse Vyavasadmika buddhi rekeha kurunandana, nishchayatmika buddhi. So Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says that the instruction which I have received from my spiritual master, that is my life and soul. This is called nishchayatmakavadeva, means assurance. Whatever I have received, the order from my spiritual master, that will give me salvation. Or even no salvation, it doesn't matter. A real devotee, a servant, does not expect anything, but karjam, it is my duty. It is my duty. If one takes in such spirit, anasita karma phalam karjam karma karoti ja. Karjam, karjam means it is my duty. It must be done. That's my duty. Without any result, anasita karma phalam. Karma phalam, every action, there is a result. Bad or good, it doesn't matter. There must be some result. So, anasita karma phalam. Don't take shelter of the result of your work. Generally, we work. If the result is very good, then we like to work. If the result is not very good, then we don't like to work. But a devotee should not take, why you are moving so fast?
I have difficulty with my body, so I stay moving.
So by moving you shall be cured?
Well, I'm sorry.
Anasita karma phalam karjam karma karoti. Do not take shelter of your result of your activity. You must take it as duty. He is sannyasi. Anasitam karma phalam kajam karma karoti ya. Sa sannyasi. He is actually sannyasi. Sannyasi does not become simply by changing dress. No. Sannyasi means he is to work for Krishna. Without taking shelter of the result, it doesn't matter. Krishna has ordered, and Krishna's representative has ordered, therefore I have to do it. Karjam karma karoti. Sa sannyasi. So here, Bhagavan Uvaj. Vyasadeva does not say that Krishna Uvaj. If you would have said Krishna, then people would have misunderstood. He is directly speaking Bhagavan Uvaj, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So anyone who is impersonalist, how he can understand Bhagavad Gita? Bhagavan means person. Bhagavan is not impersonal. The absolute truth is manifested in three features: Brahma, Paramatma, Bhagavan. Brahma is the beginning, impersonal. Sarvam idam khalu Brahma. Because just like fire is burning somewhere, but its heat and light is impersonal. Suppose here is big fire, just like we got fireplace. That is in one corner, where the whole room you are feeling heat. That heat is impersonal. But the fireplace, where there is blazing fire, that is personal. So impersonal conception is the offshoot of the person. That will be explained in the 13th chapter. Maya tatamidam sarvam, Krishna said, that everyone, everywhere I am spread. I exist everywhere. How does he exist? By his energy. That energy is impersonal. But the Supreme Person, he is not impersonal. He is personal. Therefore it is said, see, Bhagavan Ubhaj. Bhagavan means who is full with six kinds of opulence. Aishwarya, the richest, the most famous, the most learned, the most beautiful, the most strong, and the most renounced. He is Bhagavan. So Bhagavan is the ultimate understanding of the absolute truth. Just like when you feel temperature, just like we feel temperature from the sunshine, heat and light. The sun is giving heat and light. Everyone can we enjoy the light and heat. But if you trace where from this heat and light is coming, then you go to the sun planet. That is localized. That is not impersonal. And again, if you enter into the sun planet, then you will see the sun god, Vivasan. So we should not conclude final simply by heat and light. So Brahma understanding, impersonal understanding of the absolute truth is imperfect understanding, partial understanding. It is not full understanding. Full understanding is Bhagavan. Therefore it is stated here, Sri Bhagavan Uvaca. There cannot be any mistake that is final. So Bhagavan is criticizing. Arjuna became a very good man. Why is he alive? I cannot kill my kinsman. From material point of view, people will very much appreciate. Here is Arjuna, he is so nice, non-violent. He is foregoing his claim. He has given up his astra, bow and arrows. He is no longer fighting, he has decided not to fight with kings, but kill his own men. So, from material point of view, Arjuna is supposed to be very, very good man. But the Supreme Person, Krishna, what does he say? Anarjo justam. You rascal, you are speaking like Anarjo. He'll say rascal later on. He posed himself to be a very good man. But when it comes to the test of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he refuses to accept him as a good man. He is saying that you are Anarjo. There are two kinds of men. Anarjo and Arjo. Aryan. Aryan means advanced in knowledge. He's called Aryan. And Anarja means uncivilized. So immediately he rebukes him. Anarja Jista. You are talking just like non-Aryan, uncivilized person. People are very much nowadays eager how to stop war. But Krishna says, at any case, it's not required. There is necessity of war. Just like he is trying to convince Arjuna. Our war means, according to Vedic civilization, there is dharma-juddha, religious fight. When the actual need is there to fight, we must fight. Not that when there is need of fight, one becomes non-violent. Just like yesterday in the evening, when you are talking with Dr. Sumika. So they were supporting that why should you kill any animal who is coming to, if you are determined not to kill, we are talking about not killing, so why should you kill an animal who is coming to attack? No, you must kill. That is necessity. You should not go to the forest to find out some living entities, living beings to kill. That is not your business. That is hingsa. But if a tiger comes to attack you, you must kill. That is self-defense. And that is not hingsa. So a devotee knows, a Krishna conscious person knows when to kill and when not to kill. But it is not that because we accept not killing, therefore in every case killing should be stopped. No. If there is necessity, killing should be accepted. Therefore, Arjuna decided not to kill, not to fight. And Krishna says that this is anarja dushtam. This kind of decision is made by the uncivilized dasa. Anarja dushtam. Asargam. Akirtikaram. So many things, he says. Asargam. Because the aim of human life should be to make progress. That is called Arjuna. Progressive march. Now we have got this human form and body progressing from the lowest species of life in aquatic, then trees, plants, insects, birds, beasts. 8,400,000. Now I have got this civilized form of body. Then my endeavor should be how to make further progress. This further progress is described in the Bhagavad Gita. That you can go to the higher planetary system. Udangachanti sattva swa puna. Higher planetary system. Madhya tishanti rasa. Madhya, in the middle planetary system, those who are contaminated with the passion quality, they remain within. And jagannana guna vittista adhogachanti namasa. And those who are miscreant, jagannana guna vittista, most hatefully accustomed, this hatefully accustomed, illicit sex, meat eating, gambling, intoxication. These are habits of hateful nature. So they are jagannana guna vittista. Adhogachanti tamasa, they go down. And they become animals or there are same kinds of lower planetary system. Tal, atal, nital, patal, tal, atal, rasatal, like that. So, arjya means must make progress. Anarjya means one who does not know what is progress of life. They think there is no life after death. So I have got this life now. Let me enjoy my senses to the best capacity. This is anarjya, demo. Eat, drink, be merry and enjoy. Because that's why the body will be finished, the senses also will be finished, body means the senses. So, they do not know that there is life after death. They think that as soon as the professor in Europe, they say like that. After death, everything is finished. Charvak Muni's theory. This kind of theory was accepted long, long ago. In the Vedic culture, not accepted, was hard. But it was accepted. Charvak theory. Charvak theory was atheist. He was not a bitch. So his philosophy was atheistic philosophy. He used to say that must be bhutasya dehasya kutava punarāga. Very bodily concept of life. What is talking of this body? Deha.
Death, it is burnt into ashes.
So he used to say, when the body is burnt into ashes, then where is the chance of coming back? That means he had no information at all.
Accepted by the Vedic civilization.
The Aryan theory is, what is next life? What is next life? Progressive. That is Arjuna.
So that civilized man.
They may think like that. But you are belonging to the Arjuna family, part of family. Okirti Karo. You are celebrated as Krishna's friend.
So what people will say? The Krishna's friend, he is not fighting. Therefore, akirti karam, reputation, defamation it is. Don't do this. And he says, kutastha akasmalam idam viṣami samupasti. And in this, at this time of danger, there is fighting, you have to fight in viṣami. At this time of danger, you are so much bewildered that you give up your weapons down and now you promise that, no, I shall not fight. So immediately, Arjuna was condemned. Therefore, the so-called good men of this world who are engaged in so many welfare activities, humanitarian activities, by mental concoction, they may be all foolish activities in the estimation of the Supreme Personality of God. They are very much papra that we are doing this opening hospital and school and philanthropism, nationalism. Is there any such thing in the Bhagavad Gita? Is there any advice that you open a hospital, a school, and do this philanthropic work? No? If you have got anything to give in charity, you are charitably disposed, Krishna says, give it to me. If you are so rich, and if you have got this good intention to give in charity, give it to me. Jat karosi, jat juhosi, jat asnasi, jat tapasasi, dadasi jat. Dadasi jat means whatever you give in charity. Kurushatar madarpanam. Give it to me. Yes, I am expanding my hand. Come on. But they have forgotten Krishna or Krishna's advice. And they are very really papta that I am engaged in this activity, that activity, this activity. Thousands of, millions of such activities may be very good in the estimations of the fools and dastards, but it may not be accepted by Krishna. That is the crucial point. But our point is that unless accepted by Krishna, it is simply samayeva hi kevalam, simply waste of time. Our philosophy. We have to satisfy Krishna. We haven't got to satisfy ourselves that I am doing very nice work in this way. So all these people are manufacturing concocted ideas. Manorathena asato dhavato vahi. By mental concoction. Rava bhaktasya kuto mahadaguna. Manorathena asato dhavato bahi. One who is not Krishna conscious, not devotee of Krishna, he has no good qualification. No, he's a very big man, he has opened such big, big hospital, big, big school, big, big, big. Yes, that may be good from the material estimation. But because he is not a devotee of Krishna, these are not good qualities. Harava, this one word. Haro avhaktasya, harava bhaktasya. If one has no devotion to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he cannot have any good qualities. These are not good qualities. Actually, that is so. Suppose if you, according to karma kanda vichar, if you open a school, so in the next time you will have good education. It is pious activities from material point of view. So the benefit will be that you will have good education in your next life. Now suppose if I will have accepting that it is very nice, next life I shall be very learned scholar. But to become that learned scholar, I will have to take my birth. But he does not know though how much difficulties are there to take birth. Krishna says, janmamitya jara vyadhi dukkho dhushanu darshana. One should see to the dukkha, unhappiness, on account of birth and death. So suppose you will get next life in the heavenly planet, or you shall become very rich man, or you shall become very learned man. But you have to go through these distresses, janma. They do not consider this. Janma mrittu jarabhyadhi dukkho dhushan. Those who are actually learned, they should know, why shall I go again in the process of birth and death? We have forgotten how much difficulty it is, how much troublesome it is, how much distress it is to remain in the womb of the mother for taking birth again. That we have forgotten. Therefore, this kind of conclusion is not very intelligent conclusion. The intelligent conclusion is takta deham punarjanmanaiti. That is interesting. After giving up this body, no more coming to material. That is intelligence. So how many people do understand this intelligence? And where is the teaching? Therefore, one who is not devotee, he has no good qualification. If he is still under the distresses of this material world, that is not very intelligent. Therefore, Krishna says, bhavanam janmanamante jnanavan. Jnanavan means intelligent, wise. What does he do? Bhavanam janmanamante jnanavan manga prabaddhati. He surrenders to Krishna. This is intelligence. This is wisdom. So here also, the same thing. Krishna has already expressed that he must fight. But he is showing himself very good man. Non-violent. I shall not kill, I shall not do this, I shall not do this. So immediately Krishna, very strongly criticizing him, that you are talking just like an Arjuna, not civilized man. Krishna, still he has not used very strong word. He has simply a mild rebuke he is doing to Arjuna, that you are not talking just like an intelligent man or advanced in civilization. You are talking like uncivilized man, on our system. So these things are there in the Bhagavad Gita. We may be very much puffed up by our mental concoction that I am doing very nice work, but it may not be accepted by God. it may not be accepted by Krishna. You may concoct. And naturally, one who is not guided by Krishna, one is not guided by the Krishna's representative, he is fool. He must be misguided. He must be misguided. Therefore, we have to take shelter of Krishna through his representative, so that we may become Aryan. Aryan civilization means being guided by the Supreme Person, Vedic culture. That is called Aryan civilization. Vedic culture. And what is the purpose of Vedas? Vedaishta sarvai ahameva vedam. Therefore, the ultimate goal of civilization should be Aryan civilization, progressive civilization. So how to understand Krishna? That is perfect civilization. And Krishna, everything minus Krishna, that is not civilization. This is anarja justa, asadgam, akirtikaram. That is, we should not waste our time in such thing which is devoid of Krishna consciousness. That is first class civilization. Thank you.